gon' give it to ya. He gon' give it to ya. X gon' give it to ya. He gon' give it to ya. First we gonna fuck, then we gonna fall. Then we let it pop, don't let it go. X gon' give it to ya. He gon' give it to ya. X gon' give it to ya. He gon' give it to ya. Hey guys, thanks for swinging by. So, coming back with some alternative comics, some new wave outlaws, Wonder Comics to be exact. This publisher, Wonder Comics, only lasted 2 years, from 1985 to 1987. And this is G.I. Rambot. This was one of the titles. Oh, my wire is in the way here. Hold on a second. So yeah, they only lasted 2 years. You might have come across some of these quarter bin heroes. Titles were called Hero Alliance, Power Factor, Terraformers. Tom Lyle art. It's a cross between G.I. Joe, Transformers, Rambo. And we also have credits here. Tom Lyle pencils and Kevin Jouer. I think he's the creator and the writer. Really awesome. Reminds you of the Tom Scioli GoBots. Hey, guys. He's part of the kayfabe crew. So basically an ex-soldier who can't stay away from the military. He re-enlists and he goes pretty psycho. The U.S. government has this project that they're working on called G.I. Rambot. Oh, by the way, the main protagonist, his name is Ram Stewart. Great coloring. I love these colors here. So yeah, he's like super, you know, obsessed with the military. Gets shot in the head. He was resorted to pushing carts in the warehouse. So this is the future where machines and robots do all the fighting for them. He won't have none of that. So they just introduce him to the project that they're working on. He's like, get me out of this bed. G.I. Rambot. And he goes crazy. PTSD kicks in. So transforms into a vehicle and he's out of there. Super fun. They only made one issue of this, guys. One issue of this gem. So here are the titles that I was mentioning earlier by Wonder Comics. There's Hero Alliance. Bargain Books. That's what I'm talking about. And after Wonder Comics, guys, Pied Piper Press took over the rest of the issues. There you go. That's a great cover. Doesn't it remind you of the Rogue Trooper 2000 AD? So I was really excited to finally come across a copy of New Master issue number one. Terrence, my good friend Terrence, Comic Crack, has been talking about this for a couple of months now. So I need some more issues, then I'll eventually get to reading it. But I'm glad to have finally found the copy. Hey guys, I was a kid in the 80s and I totally remember the ninja craze from back then. It was nuts. It was crazy. I was all in on ninjas. I actually used to dress up like a ninja for fun, you know, ride on my bike, dress up as a ninja and make those smoke bombs. So here is Ninja Funnies, Eternity Comics, issue number one from 1987. Here's the creators, Dale Barry, Ken Sperry. Check out the art. Tell me what you guys think. So what are they trying to accomplish here? Their dream was to create a synthesized Asian American utilizing cinematic elements in the comic medium. The intent was to reach the audience of movie freaks, comic book fans, and martial arts movie buffs. A cross between King Hu and John Carpenter. I don't know, guys. I see some Frank Miller in this. What do you think? I didn't enjoy the read too much. Someone might get a kick out of this. That's a great back cover there. So I got two copies in the quarter bin. I'm gonna put one up on eBay. I already got an offer for $600. Another copy of Brat Pack by Rick Veitch. I absolutely love this run. It's just another double from the quarter bin grab. So I posted a comic book life on Twitter the other day, and Comic Crack reached out. A whole bunch of people came out and said, Blue Comet, comics, awesome. He posted a bunch of books from that run. I told him, man, it's Bladesman. I know Bladesman. Sounds really familiar. I had it in my latest back issues to feature in videos already processed, and it's a signed copy by Greg Storman. So, Blue Comet, this is amazing. Fantastic art. Yeah, creator, writer, pencils, finishes, letters, tones by Greg Storman. I've said it before, I'm not really into the fantasy, but holy smokes, this is incredible. I love this artist's line work. The inking is exceptional as well. Oh, did I say the year? I probably messed up on the year, guys. I'm sorry. 1993. Wow. The cover was actually done by Tim Vigil. I'll shoot some close-ups on here. Well, this one looks kind of busy from my end. I'm not a fan of the smaller panels. I think it deserves bigger. There you go. Great stuff. A tale once told. The Bladesman, the Scourge of Calacus. I don't know how many issues this went for. I think it's three. I had it in my CLZ processed under three issues, I think. Or that's the only issues they had available that I could check down for cataloging purposes. Very nice. Very nice. Can't wait to pick up more Blue Comet comics. Here's some back issues. So I got a list right here, a checklist. I got Life Brigade, which is the one I just showed on Twitter. I'll be showing in the future video. Oh, they have a second printing. I wonder which printing I have. Rough Riders, Roller Coaster Special, Rough Raiders, sorry. I say Rough Riders. I think I was thinking of DMX from the intro. Vehrement Special. Zoran, Star Warriors, Power Stars, Partners in Peril. Anyways, great stuff. Whoa, check that back cover. My goodness. That's absolutely beautiful. Oh, this is an issue zero. This is not an issue one. Boy, do I feel special now. Fantastic. Thanks, Comic Crack, Blue Comic Comics. I am going to be hitting them hard. Okay, this is an oddball, the Traveler's Pub. Issue number three from Magic Comics, created by Brad Staggs, art by Kevin Halter. So they're superhumans, and they emphasize that they are not mutants, but they are superhumans. There's actually a term that they use called meganoids or something. It's printed on at-slick paper, not newsprint. The art is okay, but basically the comic book takes place in the pub. It's superhumans who hang out in the pub. And there's also some, of course, the typical parody in an alternative comic book from this time. Over here, there's an X-Men cameo coming up. It's not too bad. The shiny's looking good on the camera, I think. There we go. We have Gambit, Wolverine. Is the booze okay, bub? We didn't hear any boom, Ohm. So we were hoping. Oh gosh. Yeah, whatever. Oh, there's the boom. Yeah, I don't know. I doubt I'll come across issue one and two, but it'd be nice to complete the collection. Just hit those quarter bin hard. Hit those quarter bins a little harder, I guess. Magic Comics, I never heard of them. Notes and ramblings from the publisher. And I'm bored. Dark Angels. Something, it looks like something I could pull off. Oh God. No, it's too horrible.
Kermit the Frog.
Yeah, I won't be flipping through these. If you have a problem with it, then get the fuck off my channel. Paul Ryan O'Connor, Brian Carson. I know nothing about this title. The floating head skull over here. This, I guess I'm assuming he's the main protagonist because I flipped through it earlier on. He reminds me of the of a character from Beetlejuice, the animated series, the cartoon Beetlejuice. Put it right here. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. Very similar. This is issue two, so that was issue three. That was issue two. X gonna give it to you, gonna give it to you. X gonna give it to you, gonna give it to you. X. Narcoleptic Man, Tim Kurtz, created by Tim Kurtz and Tony Furtado. This book, do you know what I love about it? Is this sticker price right here. That is from the Hairy Tarantula, an institution, a comic book institution in Toronto. If you're ever in town, oh, are they still around? I think so. I don't know. So, Narcoleptic Man, Tony Furtado, he created that Triple X Xena porno princess, very adult comic. Now, this is weird. Look at this. This is on the cover. This is supposed to be he's hiding behind a plant, but they made it look short and shriveled. So Narcoleptic Man, the title explains it all. He's a guy that Forta winks at 80 miles per hour. He has that sleeping disorder, and he's in bed with this superhero called Easy Girl, and she's like, "Is that it?" You know, they're just in bed watching t television, and he fell asleep. I like Tony Furtado's art. He's done a bunch. He's done a bunch of parody. Oh gosh, do I say it? Like parody porno. I don't know, man. That's the genre. That's the genre they call it. So don't be freaking out on me. But it reads really, really well. What the heck is that? She's putting glue on her boobs. What the? Fun read. He's actually hilarious. Yeah, he can't a superhero who falls asleep every minute or so. Makes for a fun story. What's his name again? Forgot his name. Tim Kurtz, the creator. He has web comics online. So some more. Oh, it's like an anthology. This is a different story now. Okay, anyways. Writers are Canadian. I know that. Shane Simmons, and says right here, these guys are Canadian. Troy Hickman. I think Magnetic Ink. That's, he owns it. Tim Kurtz owns Magnetic Ink. You can go online, check it out. And that's it. Last but not least, this was a pretty fun find. Bloody Lines and Black Eyed Peas, plus The Demon Game. Pencils are done by Ben Dunn. He is the creator of Ninja High School and also the co-founder of Antarctic Press Comics. The cover here looks familiar. This art, these painted covers. Yes, from Charleston. Pat Boyette. No, sorry. Yes, it is Pat Boyette. That's right. The Charleston guy. He also did some inks and he did the lettering. So that's really cool. And he did a story in the back. I'm not sure if it's a reprint from a Charleston horror comic. But this is fun. This is a lot. This looks like a lot of the like the stuff I used to read when I was a kid. Similar to this. Not House of Mystery, not House of Secrets, but some odd horror comics I used to get. They were like practically free. So this is from Pat, The Demon Game. I'm not sure if there is a signature. I'm not sure if this is a reprint Or he did it for this comic. Oh no, he actually made it. No, 1984. No, he was alive and kicking at the time. That's really cool. The narrator's there from the old vintage comic book anthologies from Charleston. Same color as throughout. It looks very vintage. For 84, they try to like harken back to those early pre-code horrors there. And he left the back at slick in monochrome. Okay. Lordings of Yore. All right, guys. Hope you liked this episode of Comic Soup 4. Like to keep it short because I like opening up the comic books and showing you the guts. Stay tuned for more, and thanks for watching.